It is amazing how something as simple as the pea crop could have such an interesting story behind it. Introduced some 30 years back, the humble pea has drastically improved the lives and fortunes of the people living in Pin Valley and Spiti. This story of the peas is the story of the synergy that exists between the people of Pin Valley, their animals, and the mountains in their backyard. The story of the peas surprisingly begins with the yaks. Yaks are raised in Pin Valley for one primary purpose, which is to plow the fields for the cultivation of the pea and barley crops. Cows are raised separately for their milk, so there is no need for the female dimos, and you will find only the male yaks in Pin Valley. The yaks are put to work during the ploughing season for about a week, and then they are left to roam free in the mountains for the duration of the summer and autumn months. Even in this freedom, the yaks serve an important purpose by converting the grass they eat into fuel. The dung they produce dries naturally in this high altitude desert, and this dry dung or gobar is an excellent fuel which the villagers use for cooking and heating their homes during the harsh winter months. It is hard to imagine the people surviving the winters without this precious gift from their yaks. There is one other unwilling contribution from the yaks. Vegetables hardly grow at this altitude, so the yak meat is an important source of nourishment for the people, especially during the harsh winter months. The meat from a yak is usually divided between a group of villagers. It is dried and used in small quantities throughout the winter. This might look cruel to some, but it reflects the hard practical realities of life in such remote places. There is nothing lost or wasted in life, especially in this village life in the mountains. Despite their premature end, the yaks do have a good life in Pin Valley. They work hard for a few days during the ploughing season and then enjoy their freedom for the rest of the year by roaming free in the mountains. The villagers check up on their animals every few months and give them some extra nourishment in order to ensure that they are well fed and healthy. The yaks are brought home during the winters and the villagers take care of them for about 3 to 4 months. They are set free after the fields are ploughed in the spring and the snow has melted in the mountains. Good winter snowfall is essential for a good harvest, and Pin Valley generally gets a lot of snowfall during the winter months. But all the snow needs to melt before the villagers can plough their fields. The villagers prepare for the sowing season by sprinkling dirt on their fields to accelerate the melting of the snow. The topsoil of their fields needs to be dry and crumbly in order for the ploughing to start. The ploughing season starts around the first week of April. Different villages in the valley start ploughing at different times based on the amount of snowfall they receive. For instance, the Mudh village receives the most amount of snowfall in Pin Valley, and naturally, it is the last village to start ploughing. The Yaks are the stars of the ploughing season. They are given extra rations of food to keep them strong, and their hair is trimmed to keep them cool during the hot slog in the days to come. The trimmed hair is not wasted and it is used for making ropes. Ploughing is very hard work for both the people and the yaks, especially if the ground is hard or rocky. The villagers coax the yaks into doing this hard work by singing songs which praise the strength and beauty of the yaks. Bit by bit, the fields are ploughed. And the seeds are sown by the family elders. The final job is to level the ploughed fields, and it is the easiest and the most fun job in the entire process. The women take over after the fields are ploughed. It is their responsibility to remove the weeds and keep the fields well irrigated until the harvest time in July. The pea crop is the main and sometimes the only source of income for the people in Pin Valley. So the pea harvest is the most important time of the year, when all their hard work during the previous months would finally pay off. The harvest happens around the end of July. Like ploughing, it also happens at different times in the different villages. Friends and family come from neighboring villages to help out during the harvest time, and extra labor is also employed sometimes to ensure that the harvest is completed in time. The harvested peas are packed in large gunny sacks, each one of which weighs around 50 kilograms. Large trucks roll into the village every evening to collect the harvested peas. The sacks are weighed and records are maintained so that the contractor knows exactly how much to pay each of the farmers. This process is repeated for about a week until all the peas are harvested in the village. Thank you. The uprooted pea plants are collected, dried and stored indoors for feeding their animals, especially the yaks, during the winters.